Yo, what's up guys, back again with me Mato. Today's in the video I'm gonna show you how I combine and manipulating these images using Adobe Photoshop to become surreal t-shirt design like this. Meanwhile, I'm gonna show all my inside process design from scratch to finish. I also divide my step process in several parts and hope gonna be helpful for you to work with your own project. So without further ado, let's get started. Alright, first of all, I'm gonna start with cropping the images one by one and do some adjustment in each image, which will make it easier for me to make an initial composition while I'm assembling all that images. Yeah, you're gonna see this process is all about cropping, assembling, and positioning all that stuff until I find the good composition, which I'm pretty sure to done with it. And so, because all this process takes a lot of time and is definitely very tedious, I'll just speed that part up and talk to you in a bit. Alright, after all the images are in the composition I want, now I will balancing the color tone in each image so that the blend and looks pop together. This time I don't want to make it seem fancy looks, but I will bring out the original tones with a low saturation. I am just using a level for increase the contrast and hue saturation to set up the color tones and play with saturation over there and try to set all these things like a vintage retro style. Yeah, I'm gonna speed it up this process and talk to you in a bit. Next up is I want to bring all these things more lively by adding shadows. I'm painting it using a brush tool. There's no fancy way to be able doing that. Just set your brush to soften brush and play with flow value, and you can go to painting it into your design. Alright, to make this design not look flat and boring, I will change the color of the snake to gold color. I think it can be more dynamic and pop with that color in my design. I use gradient maps to change or adding some of colors into it, and playing with the slider to set up the best color transition. By the way, if you really want to know how I adding color into images, I have made tutorial of it. You can check this out in the pop-up on the top right corner. Alright, for now I think it's good enough for my work, but I'm not sure that can be my perfect result. So now I did a bit of color adjustment again for optional touch. I go to my camera raw filter and playing a bit with slider over there, and also adding a noise little bit to increase the sharpness of my design. I am also adding some of element like crack overlay and combine it with my dirty texture. I should always experiment these things when I designing. Sometimes the results really sucks me. And lastly, I got the perfect adjustment to the design, and I'm really happy with it. Now, this is the time when I adding some of text in it and play with another element for different approach. And when I'm feeling good enough with all my design composition, I go to apply the design to a short mockup and show you the final results. Alright guys, so that it's all for today. I hope you learned something new from this video. I'll be uploading another video later this week, so make sure you subscribe so you don't miss out. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram for more behind the scenes. Thanks for watching my video. See you on the next one. Peace.